Welcome back, Pokefans, to part 12 of my Pokemon Shield Nuzlocke challenge. And here is my current team. I have really not trained them up as I think they're actually quite ready for the 8th gym badge. And you know what? Let's go ahead and challenge the 8th gym and see how it goes. I think we are at a good level, even though Snips over there is actually over leveled. The main reason why this is happening is because Snips was a traded Pokemon, so it does get a lot of EXP, more than my other team members. Now this means that the more further I go, the more higher level Snips will be from my other team members, which I think is totally fine since we do have the champion battle around level 60. Now I've gone ahead and healed up my team members and I am a bit nervous about the 8th gym. You might remember that the 8th gym in this game is actually gonna be a double battle, even with the main gym leader. So it's gonna be a bit trickier. I need to make sure that both of my Pokemons are gonna be at a good health before I, you know, go ahead and use a move. So usually when we have a double battle, there is a higher chance of losing your team members. So that's the reason why I'm actually making sure that I do have a really good team where I can just go ahead and just use these two Pokemons to defeat the gym leader. But anyway, I did go ahead and just talk to the NPC right here and we are actually making our way to the vault. That's the room that we were with Professor Sonia before. And we are going to be having our trainer battles over there. So we do have around 3 trainer battles and all the 3 are going to be again a double battle. We do need to actually go ahead and win those. But I'm actually fairly confident that I can actually go ahead and defeat them as well. Anyway, here we are and here is Raihan himself. He is going to be checking out our battles. And I think I'm really excited for this one. So let's see how we actually do against the gym trainers. Because they are the much easier ones than the gym leader himself. So let's see how this one goes. Now the first trainer we are up against is apparently Sebastian. And he is going to be having 2 Pokemons. Each of these trainers over here have a own theme for themselves. So let's see what kind of theme Sebastian over here is going to have. Alright. Now, I have gone ahead and switched up my team members a bit. Sebastian does have a Pelipper and a Sliggoo, which is actually a really good combination to have. Pelipper does have Drizzle, which means that it will actually increase the power of water type Pokemons. So, I thought this might actually help Dreadnought. So, I went ahead and added it into my team. I also have Snips up in front. Just to make sure that I am able to take down the Sliggoo as soon as possible. And of course, I'll go ahead using Rock Tomb on the Pelipper. That should actually take down the Pelipper at least. Alright, Sliggoo is down by half health, which is pretty good. And Pelipper is almost down as well. Alright, I think one more move from both of my team members should be able to take down this trainer. And it seems like at least Sliggoo had, attacked Dreadnought. I was actually hoping that it would attack Snips. But anyway, this turn we should be able to take both of them down. I actually decided to go ahead and use Liquidation in the end, as it's already drizzling and it should be a much powerful move because of that. And there goes Sliggoo. Alright. I really like Sliggoo. I mean, it's pretty unique, especially the Sliggoo from Pokemon Legends Arceus. The design over there is amazing. But I'm really not sure what kind of design they might actually have in case if they add Sliggoo in the newer game, that is Pokemon Violet and Scarlet. That would be a bit, surprising for us if they actually add the form of Sliggoo from Pokemon Arceus. But I don't think they will since, you know, Arceus is supposed to be a game that was in an earlier generation. Anyway, here we have defeated the first trainer pretty easily. Not that difficult. But thankfully, we do have a chance of actually healing our Pokemons before we start the second battle over here. That's a pretty good thing. So let me quickly heal my Pokemons. Now, even though this is the first time I'm actually playing a Nuzlocke challenge, I'm actually enjoying this. I think I enjoy Nuzlocke challenges more than the normal playthroughs that I do. So I might actually try and do a Nuzlocke challenge in the future games as well. So if you have any game recommendation for me, any of the Pokemon games that you want me to try a Nuzlocke challenge on, please let me know. I'll be really excited to do that. Anyway, here we have the second trainer and she has an amazing combination of Ninetales and Turnitore. They both are pretty good as Ninetale is a good backup for Turtonator over here. At least that's how I think it's pronounced. I'm really sorry if I pronounce any of the Pokemon names a bit wrong. But my focus over here would be to just take down the Turtonator. I think that's more of a threat than Ninetale itself. Now I should have had my ground type Pokemon over here. That would have actually taken both of their Pokemons down. Maybe I should have switched up something like Flygon and Kovanite. I think that team would have been much better for these two Pokemons. But anyway, with Snips and Dredna over here, I still think we can easily take down these two Pokemons. So no issues. Alright, at this point I'm actually thinking maybe having Fairy Wind is really not enough for my Snips over here. I believe that Togekiss doesn't really learn any other kind of, I guess, a Fairy type move. So I might have to actually teach it a new one. Fairy Wind isn't just doing that much damage. Alright, seems like Ninetales is the only one left. And I think I can actually take it down. Even my Togekiss over here has Ancient Power. That should be easily able to take down the Ninetales. If not, I do have Rock Tomb from my Dredna. Anyway, it seems like Togekiss special attack is really good. So I guess I should be focusing more on moves that are not physical for Togekiss, as that will actually help it a lot. Anyway, we were easily able to defeat the second trainer as well. Now I'm actually feeling much better and actually feeling really confident on the 8th gym. I guess the 8th gym battle against the gym leader. But we still have one more trainer left, so let's go ahead and battle her as well. I'll also go ahead and just heal up my team members before starting this battle with her. Alright, here we go. Let's see what kind of Pokemon she has. The first trainer had a fire type dual Pokemons. The second one had a water type. So I'm actually intrigued to see what kind of combination this third trainer will have. I guess I'm really surprised with the combination of Pokemons these trainers come up with. Seems like she has a dragon and an ice type Pokemon. Alright, I think I'll focus more on taking down Abomasnow first as it's a grass type Pokemon. And Dredna over here is really not good against a grass type. So that should be my first focus. So let me actually target my moves against it. I think I can actually take care of the dragon type Pokemon in a later stage. Alright, that was a pretty good hit. It almost took it down. And since Dredna is even faster than Abomasnow, I was really lucky over here and we were able to take it down before it could use any of its grass type moves against my Dredna. So that was pretty cool. Alright, so now that we have taken one of our Pokemon down, now even though my Togekiss's attack and special attack is down, I think we can still win this battle. Anyway, it seems like my Pokemons are a bit higher level for this battle. I mean, all of these trainer Pokemons were around level 45. But I believe the gym leader Rehan will have a Pokemon around level 49. So we should be good. And And there we go. We have defeated all the three gym trainers. Now, this is a unique gym mission, as you know, we didn't really have any kind of mazes to go through or any other tasks to complete for this. Just going ahead and battling three of these trainers. Again, as usual, you know, just like the 7th gym, I wish there was something more for this gym over here. At least a bit of a challenge, other than, you know, the double battles that we have gone through. Anyway, I think the double battle concept for the 8th gym is pretty unique and it's a really good challenge for us. Usually double battles are not that easy, and you know, you never know what will happen whenever you're in a double battle. There are pretty good team members, you know, team combinations where, you know, it is pretty easy to actually lose against them. And that's the main thing I had for this 8th gym. I was a bit worried that Rehan will be able to, you know, defeat my team members, as he does have a group of, I guess, a ground type Pokemon. So I need to be a bit careful with this one. Now, I did decide to bring out Dredna and my Flygon in the beginning. I believe my Flygon is much faster than his, so we should be able to easily take down first pair of his Pokemons, which is his own Flygon and Gigalith over here. Alright, since both of my team members are actually part rock and ground type, I won't really get hurt by the sandstorm that's actually brewing up. So this should be quite fun. Now, my main goal over here is to take down that Gigalith, or else it will start using its moves and it's gonna be way much tougher for me, especially when it goes ahead and uses Stealth Rock in the first turn. This is quite dangerous, as you know, whenever I switch my Pokemons, it will actually deal more damage. This means that my Pokemons are more prone to going down easily, so I had to make sure that the Gigalith is down. Thankfully, the Bug Buzz and Liquidation was enough to take it down, and I'm really happy for that. I think taking down the Flygon now should be much easier. And I think since my Flygon is faster, we should be easily able to take down his Flygon. Alright, this turn I did go ahead and target the Sandaconda. I decided to do this because Sandaconda does go ahead and use Glare. Again, it paralyzes your Pokemon and makes it much tougher to actually hit it. As you can see over here, my Flygon was faster and we were able to easily take down his Flygon. Alright, so that is two Pokemons of his down. And Dredna did go ahead and use Ice Beam, but I don't think that's actually enough. We do need to go ahead and use another turn. It did paralyze my Flygon, but it seems like my Flygon did actually break through. This is really lucky over here. I was not really expecting it, but I'm really happy that this happened. Alright, so he has brought out his Darulodon. So this is much trickier now. If you want to take down Darulodon, it's usually better to have a fighting type Pokemon, or a Pokemon that does know a fighting type move. That makes it much easier to actually take it down. Now, I had to bring out some of my Pokemons over here. I didn't want to keep Flygon up in front. I did finally decide to just go ahead and bring out my Scentiscotch. It does have Flame Wheel, and that should be, I guess, enough to take down his main Pokemon. Anyway, I did have to be much careful. No matter what, it's a bit trickier to actually take down his final Pokemon. Thankfully, I did switch out Flygon, as I didn't really want to take it down over there. And he is gonna be Gigantamaxing his own Pokemon. I really like the Gigantamax form of Darulodon. It looks amazing. And here it's gonna be quite powerful. Amazing. It looks like a huge skyscraper and it's really cool design. Alright, let's see who moves first. Seems like it's his Darulodon who's gonna be moving first, and it is trying to use a dragon type move. And let's see who it targets. It's my Scentiscotch. Okay. That was a bit weird. I was not expecting that. But we were able to take down his Sandaconda. This is pretty good. Now we have only one Pokemon to take down. I can either stall its turn for Dynamaxing and then maybe Dynamax myself, or just go ahead and immediately, you know, switch out my Pokemon and Dynamax. I think I should actually, you know, bring back my Sandiscotch. It might go down in the next turn, so I do have to switch it out. But I think Dreadnought can stay there. I think it's pretty cool in its position and I'll just let it be there for now. But anyway, let's see who we can actually switch out for Sandiscotch. I think the best bet would be my Cobonite over here, as it doesn't really get hit by the Sandstorm. And it does have a fighting type move, so we still have a bit of a chance to actually take down the Ruledon. Alright, here we have my Cobonite. And let's see who does the Garuladon really attack this turn. And it's using Max Rockfall. And of course it goes for Cobonite, why not? It seems to get much luckier. Really, I was not expecting this, but okay. Now, I think I'll go ahead and just use Rock Tomb on Garuladon. And I'll actually go ahead and Dynamax my Cobonite. Let's see how much damage this is gonna do. I'm actually hoping that my Cobonite will not go down over here. And if I'm saying Duraludon as wrong pronunciation, please forgive me. I do not know how to pronounce it. I'm just guessing that's how it's being pronounced. Anyway, let's see how Cobonite does over here. Alright, it's at a pretty good health, so it shouldn't be much tougher. Also, I'm using Rock Tomb because I do want to actually decrease the speed of Duraludon over here. And, okay, not bad. I think it raises the attack as well. So the next turn, the move will be much powerful. And Duraludon does use, oh, okay, it almost took down my Dreadnought. All right. I see you. I know what you're trying to do. I will just go ahead and switch out my Dreadnought. I do not want to lose it. It's an amazing Pokemon and it's the only water type Pokemon that I have. So it's quite important that I actually keep it alive. And I guess I'll switch out to Rillaboom. Why not? I mean, it didn't really get that much action in this gym challenge anyway. And I'll go ahead and try using Max Knuckle again. My Cobonite should be able to at least take one hit, so I'm actually pretty good with that over there. And I believe we should be able to take down the Duraludon over here in this turn itself. So let's see how it goes. And we did take it down. Alright, that was pretty amazing. This gym challenge was tough. I really don't know how I was able to still keep my Pokemon alive. It was much tougher, but I think we had a really good team members, you know. I'm really happy that we were able to go ahead and win all the 8 badges. This is amazing. I'm really happy that I was able to come this far. And we are finally getting the 8th gym badge. So that's actually gonna complete the whole coin that we're having with all the 8 gym badges over there. I think that is one of the designs I really like. Usually in the Pokemon games, we just have 8 gym badges that are actually quite separate from each other. And the badge case is also, I guess, a normal thing in all the other Pokemon games. But this one is really creative. I really like that we are actually creating a whole coin by getting all the 8 gym badges. So that's amazing. And now that we have defeated the 8 gyms, we finally are able to go ahead and move on to Route 10. This is amazing since we have only one more chance to catch a Pokemon. Route 10 is Ice type Pokemon, so I'm actually hoping to get a Ice type Pokemon for my team. Let's see how it goes. I'm really excited. And we do have to, I guess, go ahead and travel through the train again. The last time we did travel in the train was when we first came to Motostoke. And now we are actually letting go of this whole place and moving on from here. So this is pretty cool. Alright, here is Hop himself. He is gonna be challenging the gym. We don't really have anything much to do over here in Hammerlock. So I guess we can actually make our way through and go to the Hammerlock station. We do have a small cutscene over there. And I think I might actually go ahead and, you know, skip out that cutscene as well. Anyway, I'm pretty happy the way the 8th gym went. The gym battle went. Now, the only thing that's a bit worrying is the fact that I don't have a electric type Pokemon in my team. Or any Pokemon that does know a electric type move. So, if I do have to go against, I say, Nessa in the future, will be a bit tougher. Anyway, we have a small cutscene right here where Sonia gets a Professor Lab coat and she is from now on Professor Sonia, which is pretty cool. She has come so far with us in this journey as well, and it's pretty cool to see that she is getting promoted. And it's quite shocking to think that we are at the last part of this game. I mean, it didn't really feel too long. We did have at least one gym battle in almost all of these episodes. So it was a pretty good playthrough till now. And I'm really happy with my team members as well. I was quite lucky in a few areas and was able to get some really strong Pokemons. And I'm really determined to not lose these Pokemons at this point. They are quite good and I don't want to actually... lose at the last part of this game. So let's go ahead and actually try to win this challenge. Alright, here are all my team members. I'm really happy with this team currently. I think I might have to actually train them up a bit more. Maybe around level 55, just before I go ahead and go to the new area. But for now, here we are in the Hammerlock station. And we are ready to go ahead and move on. Now it seems like Hop himself has also gone ahead and got a 8th gym badge, which is pretty cool. I'm really happy that our rival is over here as well. And we are actually ready to go ahead and I guess we are gonna be going together to Route 10. It's pretty cool. Alright, so let me quickly go ahead and skip out this small cutscene as well. And I'll see you guys in Route 10. Alright, here we are in Route 10, which is actually gonna be making our way to Windom. And Route 10 is quite unique as you have snow going over here. Now, I feel like Route 10 is a bit unique as it does have ice type Pokemons as encounters over here. And I'm actually quite excited as I do want to add a ice type Pokemon, at least into my box, so that I do have a backup. Anyway, here is the first encounter and it's actually a Vanillish. Alright, it did take me some time to actually go into the grass. As you saw, there was a Mr. Mime and I think a Kerbtu that was actually blocking the path for me, so I did have to wait around 2 minutes. But finally, I was able to run into the grass and get this Vanillish as my encounter. This Pokemon is pretty cool and it's one of those Pokemons that I have never used in my playthrough as well. And since I do have some quick balls, I'll go ahead and try to catch it. Alright, let's see if we do catch it over here. And we were able to catch it. Alright, so this is the last encounter that we get before we go ahead and challenge the trainers in Windom Stadium. Alright, so I'm really excited. Now that we have caught our encounter in Route 10, I think we can actually move on and battle all the trainers over here as well. I do want to actually battle all the trainers as I think this is the last time we're actually getting to train up our Pokemons through Pokemon battles. And I guess if I do still want to, you know, go ahead and train them up, I might try using camping, but I think my Pokemons are actually at a pretty good level. Anyway, now that we have got our encounter, I think it's time for us to head on forward. I did go ahead and keep Scenty Scotch in the beginning as it's gonna help me a lot in this route. Since most of these trainers will have a ice type Pokemon. Alright, here we are. And we are ready. So let's go ahead and quickly battle this first trainer right over here. But before that, I actually forgot that there was an item over here. I did come to pick it up. Unfortunately, it's a max revive. Really not a good item for me, especially since I'm playing a Nuzlocke challenge. But I guess it's more money for me. I can actually go ahead and just sell it. Anyway, this trainer has a Gardevoir. Alright. But thankfully, my Scenty Scotch does have a poison type move, so we can actually go ahead and use it. Here we go. We have Venoshock. Now that I see this, I think only Scenty Scotch in my team has a poison type move. I am literally not prepared for any fairy type Pokemons because of this. But I don't think we'll be encountering too many of them, so we should be good. Especially with a Pokemon such as Gardevoir, I think we can actually take it down with a physical type move much easier than, you know, using Venoshock over here. Anyway, we were able to take it down in 2 hits and we have defeated the first trainer in Route 10. Alright, and seems like we are getting a lot of EXP for these battles, you know. This is actually making me quite happy. I think we'll be at least a level or two higher by the end of this route. So, this is pretty cool. Alright, so now that we have defeated him, we can actually move on. We do have another trainer right at the end of this hill. And regarding the design-wise of this route, I think it's quite unique and I really like it. We don't really have these kind of routes till now. Most of them were quite, I guess the background was almost the same. The only other routes that I really liked were the Galar Mines, as it was amazing. At least the crystal-like structures that we had in Galar Mine 2, they were actually pretty cool and I really liked it. Anyway, here we have a Steelix. I think this is the first time we're actually encountering a Steelix with a trainer. And I don't really think Scenty Scotch over here is the right Pokemon to actually go against it. But I think we can still make it through since Steelix is part Steel type. Alright, I think the hail is giving us a bit of a trouble as it does, you know, try and take us down a bit. But thankfully, I do have the leftovers, so we are still good. And I think we can actually take down the Steelix right over here. I'm actually quite happy that we are able to take down most of the Pokemons by 2 hits at least. Even though over here we were not able to take it down, I'm still happy that we are at a position where we can actually take down Pokemons with 2 hits. Alright. I think this is the last turn to take down the Steelix. But it seems like he does have another Pokemon, so I'm actually kind of puzzled. I don't know which Pokemon he might have. This turn I did decide to use Bug Bite, as you know, any of the moves will be able to take it down at that hill, so I was not really worried. And we are gonna be gaining, as usual, a lot of EXP. Alright, let's see which Pokemon he has next. And I think I won't be switching out Scenty Scotch for now. But it seems like he does have a Mudsdale, which means I really can't keep Scenty Scotch out. Now I think this is the first time again we're actually seeing a Mudsdale. This is another Pokemon that I've never used till now. I have seen it around a lot. But I think I should try and use it once. I might try and use it when I'm doing a Nuzlocke challenge with Pokemon Squad. Thinking about this, you know, I feel like Nuzlocke challenges are really exciting. Usually a normal playthrough is, I guess not that exciting as we know which Pokemon we can actually choose. But whenever we have a Nuzlocke challenge, you never know what you get. And, you know, using the Pokemons that you have is much fun. I think that's what I found out, you know, playing through this challenge. Anyway, it seems like we do have another patch of grass over here, but doesn't seem like we have any items over there. So let me go ahead, and we do have another trainer coming up. So let me actually just heal my Pokemon a bit, and I think we can move on. I mean, till now I have just used Sandy Scorch, so I don't really have to worry too much about healing. Alright, let's quickly talk to this trainer over here. And we can battle him. Alright, it seems like he's an office worker. Now this is actually new. I didn't know that there were NPCs who are actually office workers. If he's really an office worker, what is he really doing in Route 10? I mean, isn't he supposed to be in an office? Anyway, it seems like he has a Weavile, which is a really cool Pokemon. It's quite rare as well. And I think we should be able to easily take it down. Weaviles are really not that strong. They're just a lot high speed and attack. Anyway, now that we have taken his first Pokemon down, I wonder if he has a second one. And let's see what he has. Alright. He is gonna have a clay doll. Not bad. I mean, the Pokemons with these trainers over here in Route 10, they're really not disappointing me. All of these trainers have really cool Pokemons and some of them are really good. Claydol is one of my favorite ground type Pokemons in, I guess, from Gen 3. Whenever I used to play either Pokemon Emerald or Sapphire, I used to usually go ahead and use a Claydol in my team. I think it usually used to be a struggle between Claydol or, you know, Trapinch. They both are really cool Pokemons and I really love using them. Especially Claydol over here. If you want to have a psychic type hold as well, I think Claydol is an amazing team member. Anyway, I'm really excited to see what kind of Pokemons the other trainers have in this route. Now that we know they have some really good Pokemons. And here we have a Comet Shard. Not bad. That's a really good item and it sells for a lot of Pokedollars. Especially when you sell it in store on site. So if you really are short of money, just go ahead and check out store on site every single day. You will be able to get a lot more worth than when you actually sell it in a Pokemart. Anyway, here we have our next trainer with a Pelipper. I think Pelipper is a bit underrated usually. Its drizzle ability is really good, especially if you are having a water type team going on. It's a really cool, I guess, a first Pokemon for your team and it's actually quite solid. I have used Pelipper before again in Gen 3 and I really think it's underestimated by people. You know, it's just one of those Pokemons that you need to try in order to see how good it is. Anyway, I think my Togekiss can actually take it down. The reason why I switched into Togekiss is Sandy Scorch is not a good Pokemon for going against Pelipper, I guess. Now, it seems like my Togekiss is a bit confused, but thankfully it was able to hit the Ancient Power. And we were able to take down the Pelipper with a crit hit. Not bad. So I think I haven't seen this yet in this playthrough. Usually whenever you're going against a Pokemon battle and if you have the friendship level completely high for your Pokemons, they'll usually go ahead and either cure themselves from any condition like sleep, paralysis, or they'll occasionally try using a crit hit. Sometimes they will actually dodge the attacks as well. The reason why I'm not seeing this in my playthrough might be because I have never gone ahead and used camping that much. And I think the friendship level for my Pokemons in my team at least are not that great. Other than Togekiss over here, as it was a friendship evolution. Anyway, we do have a Noctowl over here. Again, another cool Pokemon from Gen 2. I just remember using an Noctowl every single time in my playthrough. I really like this Pokemon. It's quite unique and it's one of a kind out there, especially for a flying type Pokemon. I think it does hold its own place in that. Anyway, it seems like Snips is getting confused a bit. I'm actually hoping that it's actually able to take down the Noctowl over here. As you might know, I really don't have a electric type Pokemon or any Pokemon that has a electric type move. So I am in a bit of a pickle over here. I should have actually checked if any of my team members could learn a electric type move, which I forgot. So we are just gonna try with Dredna and see how it goes. Alright, here is a Dredna, and I think the next time I'm gonna do a Nuzlocke challenge, maybe with Pokemon Sword. I might try and select a few Pokemons that I've never used till now, and you know, try and use a random one from that list. Usually when I go through a playthrough of a game, I tend to use the same Pokemons as I'm actually quite sure that I can get through the game with them. But I see why using random Pokemons is much more fun. That way, I guess you have a chance to actually strategize and go through different Pokemons, see how they actually fare in a battle. And I think I got to know more about it in this playthrough, especially by using Pokemons like Scentiscorch, who I've never used in a playthrough before. Anyway, it seems like we were able to take down the Noctowl, which is good. I'll also quickly go ahead and heal up my team members as well. And now that they are healed, I'll go ahead and battle this trainer over here as well. Alright, let's see what Pokemons he has. I think the Pokemons in this route has yet to disappoint me. Alright, he has a Cobonite. Not bad, that's actually a pretty cool Pokemon. I do have one of my own and I'm actually really happy that I was able to get a Rookudee when I did it. Anyway, we should be able to take it down with a Flame Wheel. Let's see how it goes. I feel like this game has a lot of Steel type Pokemons, especially most of the NPCs do have a Steel type Pokemon. You'll be able to see it more as we go to Windun. I feel like most of the trainers over there will have it, and it's absolutely essential that you have either a Fighting type Pokemon or a Fire type Pokemon whenever you play Pokemon Shield or Sword. So that is one thing I did find out, and I'm really glad that we were at least able to save my Scentiscorch. I know I did have a Pangoro at one point in my game. I'm really sad that I actually lost it. I shouldn't have done that. But at least we didn't get too much trouble because of not having a fighting type. So that is one good thing. Anyway, over here I'll go ahead and spit out Scentiscorch as it's actually down to half health. And I'm going ahead and bringing out my Flygon. Now, I really like the goggles my Flygon has. It's just amazing. The design for this Pokemon has, I think it's one of my favorite, especially in this generation. It looks so cute. Anyway, since we were faster, we were able to take down his Flygon. And I'm pretty happy. Alright, so this whole route is making me a lot happier. I'm really happy that the trainers have some really strong, really good Pokemon. And I think they do pack a punch, you know. If you're not ready, you might actually get taken down. Anyway, let me quickly go ahead and pick up the item that's over here. And I accidentally run into the Snover over here. I think Snover is a pretty cool Pokemon, although it's quite weak. I think this is because of the typing that it has. Ice and Grass type is really not a good combination for any Pokemon. This means that it has way more, I guess, weaknesses than strength. I think that's the reason why not many people like Snover. But a Bamasno does get some really good abilities, so I guess using it is also a pretty cool thing. Anyway, we do have one more item right here. I did go ahead and pick it up. And now we can actually go ahead and climb up the slope. We do have around two more trainers in this route. So let's quickly go ahead and battle them as well. And here is a Gigalith. Alright, so this is another Pokemon that I've never used. But I think its design is pretty cool. It's actually quite nice to see one. And of course, it has the ability Sandstream. Not bad. I think this is a pretty good support to Pokemon just like Pelipper. Especially if you have Rock-type Pokemons or two in your team. That will actually help you a lot. Anyway, it seems like I shouldn't have had Sandy Scotch out over here. So I'm just going ahead and switching out to Flygon. Alright, Flygon should be able to take this Pokemon down with the Earthquake. And the Rock Slide over here really didn't do much. I'm actually happy about that. And let's see how much the Earthquake does. Alright, we were able to take it down in one hit. Not bad. I'm quite happy that we are able to take down Pokemons in one hit, even at this level. And we are quite close to the final, the finale, you know. And I guess I'm a bit nervous about the upcoming battles against a lot of trainers. We do have many battles just happening one after the other, so we do have to be a bit trained up. But at the levels we are currently, I think we should be good. Anyway, we have defeated this hiker over here as well. Now the only thing I wonder is that will these trainers really have 8 gym badges? If not, how are they really in Route 10? I mean, I'm not really sure. I guess they can actually directly just travel to Route 10. But anyway, we weren't able to do that. Now here is a Darmanitan. Again, a really cool Pokemon. And I really like the fact that they did make this a ice type over here. Before, we did have it as a fire type, and I think the design over here is much better than the older one. Anyway, we were able to take it down in one hit. And let's see which Pokemon he has next. I think he has another one. And he has the fighting type Pokemon, Flinks. I guess I'll switch out to Cobonite at this point. I can also switch out to Togekiss, but it seems like my Togekiss is actually leveling up pretty faster than the other team members. Now that's actually an advantage and a disadvantage. The advantage is that I at least have one Pokemon with whom I can actually try to beat the team in case if it comes to that. But the disadvantage is that it's the only Pokemon that I would choose whenever I am in too much trouble. Anyway, let me go ahead and try using Drill Peck. That should actually go ahead and take down the Flinks. Flinks over here is a bit of a weird Pokemon. I really don't understand the dynamics over there. I mean, is it the same Pokemon or is it multiple things just becoming one Pokemon? I really don't know. It's a bit confusing. But it seems like he has a third Pokemon and it's a Graplot. Quite cool design, and I'm really happy that, you know, they were able to actually take up this Pokemon and make it look so cool. The blue color for it is amazing and I'm really happy about its design as well. Anyway, we have defeated this trainer, so let's move on. Seems like we have the two trainers that we fought from Route 5. And this time, I think they'll have a bit of a higher level Pokemon. So, I do have to be a bit careful about it. Anyway, I'm just healing up my team members over here. Just making sure that I'm actually ready for the next battle. Let's go ahead and try to defeat them. I think they're the last trainers in this route. So this should be pretty interesting. Let's see what they have. All right, here we go. They have a Helionus who has evolved and a Clinklang. Not bad. Both of their Pokemons are fully leveled up now. And it seems like they have another two Pokemons additional added to their team. So that's pretty cool. I do have Flygon and Cyndiscorch over here. Unfortunately, I'm not able to actually use Earthquake since it might actually take down my Cyndiscorch as well. So I guess I'll just use a random move like Bug Buzz on Heliolis. It's really not my target for now. I think my target over here is actually Clinklang. So let me try and take it down with a fire type move. And alright, it's actually faster, which is quite surprising. Seems like my Cyndiscorch is not as fast as I thought it was. And of course the Clinklang did survive with 1 HP. Thankfully this route had hail, so it was going to go down. This is pretty good. Alright. Now that we have taken down one Pokemon, I think this should be much easier. And of course the experience that we're getting by, you know, defeating these trainers is a lot. It's pretty cool to see. And he has a Togedemaru, not bad. That's actually a pretty cool Pokemon. I think I'll actually go ahead and switch out to Kovanight and try using Earthquake. That way I should be able to target both of their team members over there. I mean, Earthquake is super effective on both Heliolis and Togedemaru, so I should be able to take them both down in one hit over here. Let's go ahead and see if we take them both down. And we did. Alright, so that was a double combo. I'm really happy that I have Flygon in my team. It's an amazing ground type Pokemon and a part dragon type. As you might know by now, I really like dragon type Pokemons and I never compare them with anything else. But whenever I have a chance of choosing a certain dragon type Pokemon, I think I would rather go with either Flygon or Hexerus. Those two Pokemons can never, you know, be beaten down by anything else. I know fairy type Pokemons can take care of, dragon type Pokemons pretty easily. But I think, still dragon type Pokemons are pretty cool. Anyway, here we were able to take down both of their Pokemons. I'm actually quite surprised that she had a Noivern over there. It's actually pretty cool Pokemon. It's a dragon flying type and it's one of those amazing Pokemons. But it doesn't really have that good of a defense. I think that's the most issue with that Pokemon. Anyway, we have defeated all the trainers in Route 10. This is actually quite good. We are at a good place and I think once we go to Windon, I will go ahead and end out this episode. I mean, the main thing in this episode for me was to just go ahead and complete the 8th gym and come to Windon. So this is pretty amazing. I think Windon is actually a pretty cool area. It's quite large with a lot of things going on. Especially the Windon Stadium is amazing. Its structure does resemble a lotus, or I guess it resembles a rose moreover. But I think this place is pretty cool. Alright, here you are getting a glimpse of it. And this is pretty cool. I think this resembles more of London in real world. With the Big Ben and the Clock Tower. Anyway, there's the stadium. That's where we are supposed to make our way through. But we do have a few items to pick up in Windom. I won't be going ahead and picking it up in this episode. I'll actually go ahead and just heal my Pokemons and end out this episode over here. In the next episode, we can go around this city, go ahead and pick out all of the items and then finally enter the Windon Stadium. This is quite exciting. We are near the close of this game. And this journey till now has been amazing. I really enjoyed playing this game, especially and sharing this with you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I did. Let me quickly heal up my team members, and I think we are at a pretty good level. I mean, level 53 to 54 is quite good for the beginning of the Winden Stadium, especially since the trainers over there will have Pokemons below level 50. Even though we will have to at some point train up my team members a bit more, I think for now we are at a really good place. Anyway, thank you for watching my videos. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Your support is what's getting me through all of these videos. I'm really happy to see you guys, you know, watching these videos. It makes me happy to put more. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.